Indian Ocean island of Mauritius is facing an environmental crisis. After oil began leaking from a bulk carrier that ran aground on 25th July and started to break up in rough seas. The island's environmental minister, Kavi Ramano, together with fisheries minister, told the press that it was the first time that the country has faced a catastrophe of this magnitude and that they were insufficiently equipped to handle the problem. The minister said due to rough seas, all attempts to stabilize the ship had failed and efforts to pump out the oil has also failed. Ecologists fear that the ship could break into two, which would cause an even greater leak and inflict potentially catastrophic damage on the island's coastline. The environmental minister said that there is a breach in the vessel of MV Bacchio and that led to the leakage of oil. After the leakage of oil into the ocean, the public in general, including boat operators and fishers, are requested not to venture on the beach and in the lagoons of Blue Bay, Point DNC and Mahabong. The carrier belonging to a Japanese company but Panamanian flag ran aground on 25th July and its crew was evacuated safely. According to the local press, the ship had no payload at the time but was carrying 200 tons of diesel and 3,800 tons of bunker fuel. Shipping websites say that Bacchio was built in 2007 with gross weight of 101,000 tons and able to carry 203,000 tons and the length of the ship is 299.95 meters. The grounding happened at Point Diesny, which is listed under the Ramsar Convention of Wetlands of International Importance and near the Marine Park of Blue Bay. Anti-pollution systems had been sent to the two sites. The ministry said that the government was asking the French Indian Ocean island of La Réunion for assistance. Mauritius depends on its sea for food and for tourism, boasting some of the finest coral reefs in the world. Nagashiki Shipping, which owns the Bacchio, said that it was monitoring the situation and salvage efforts were on hold due to poor sea conditions. It stated that it will take its environmental responsibilities extremely seriously, and with partner agencies and contractors will make every effort to protect the marine environment and prevent further pollution. India on Tuesday started assistance work in evacuating fuel oil from the breached Japanese vessel Bacchio in reefs of the Mauritian coast. The evacuation started Monday night after the sea swells went down. Pravin Jugnauth declared a state of environmental emergency, pleading for international help. Indian Oil Mauritius Limited had made itself available with a large barge to evacuate 1,000 tons fuel oil from the breached vessel Bacchio. Tweeting about the evacuation work, the Indian Mission in Port Louis wrote, "Standing together, Indian Oil Mauritius Limited, IOML, Barge Testa, Star, has started evacuating fuel oil in the breached vessel Bacchio." It added evacuation of 1,000 tons of fuel oil from Bacchio by barge deployed by Indian Oil Mauritius Limited in progress. Unlike most previous offshore spills, this has taken place near two environmentally protected marine ecosystems and the Blue Bay Marine Park Reserve, which is the wetland of international importance. So, it's the location rather than the size of the spill which is causing greatest concern about the potentially serious environmental impact. The stunning Turkish borders of Blue Lagoon outside the coastal village of Mahabong in Mauritius is now stained black and brown. The ship MV Bacchio ran aground at Point Diesny in late July. In case of Mauritius, having access to underlying technologies like cloud computing, machine learning and quantum computing have allowed authorities to rapidly access from where MV Bacchio has started travelling, what cargo it was carrying, what trajectory it was on and what risk it posed. According to the satellites, oil began leaking from it since last Thursday. Satellite images show that oil spills stretched out between the mainland of Point Diesny and island of Lee Oxley Egrets. It is thought that more than 1,000 tons of fuel have leaked out of the ship into the lagoon. A huge cleanup operation has been launched from the shore with many local people volunteering to help. On 7th of August, nearly 2 weeks after the shipwreck, the Mauritian government declared the incident as a national emergency. Mauritius is a biodiversity hotspot with a high concentration of plants and animals unique to the region. Sunil Mokshananda, a former Greenpeace strategist who is on an island near the oil spill site, said that the wind and the water currents are not helping. They are taking the oil towards the areas that have vital marine ecosystems. The Mauritian marine environment is home to 1,700 species, including 800 types of fish, 17 kinds of marine mammals, and 2 species of turtles, according to the UN Convention on Biological Diversity. Coral reefs, sea grasses, and mangroves make Mauritian waters extraordinarily rich in biodiversity. Dr. Corinna Siokan, a senior lecturer in marine biology at UK's University of Brighton, said that there are very few such marine areas with such rich biodiversity left on the planet. An oil spill like this will impact almost everything there. It is not about the light oil slick you see on the surface of water caused by the spill. There will also be soluble components from the oil that will dissolve in water, mostly like layer underneath the surface of water, and a very heavy residues on the bed, so the entire marine ecosystem will be affected. According to the operator Mitsui O.S.K. Lines, the ship MV Vacatio is believed to have been carrying around 4,000 tons of fuel, of which nearly 1,200 tons has already spilled. Despite bad weather, Prime Minister Pravin Jugnauth said all the oil has now been removed from the ship's fuel reservoirs, although a small amount of oil remains on the board elsewhere. Fuel has now been transferred to shore by helicopter and to another ship owned by same Japanese firm, Nagashiki Shipping. At a news conference, Akiko Ono, Executive Vice President of Mitsui O.S.K. Lines, profusely apologized for the spill and for the great trouble we have caused. One of the major concerns has been for coral reefs in the lagoon, which are sometimes called the rainforests of the sea, because of the diversity of life found in them. According to the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration of the United States, around 25% of fish in the ocean depend on healthy coral reefs. They protect coastlines from storms and erosion. Coral reefs and the marine ecosystems are the major pillars of Mauritian tourism, which is a big part of the country's economy. Professor Richard Steiner, an international oil spill advisor and a marine biologist in Alaska, said that the toxic hydrocarbons released from the spilled oil will bleach the coral reefs and they will eventually die. Last year, Professor Steiner helped the government of Solomon Islands when a ship spilled oil on the coral reefs of its coast. Although oil spill wasn't large, just a few hundred tons of oil, the damage of coral reefs there have been massive. Professor Steen said the Mauritian government should do the environmental impact assessment as soon as they can. The impact is likely to remain for years.